Okay, so guys, now see the numerical. Okay, so this is the problem we are given over here. Write the four ways of representing an AC voltage given by a magnitude of 5 volt and frequency of 50 hertz. So guys, यहाँ पर आपको maximum voltage is given, EM is given. You can see over here, EM is equal to 5 volt and frequency equal to 50 hertz is given. Now you see guys, यहाँ पर आप ये कर सकते हैं कि ओमेगा जो है बेसिकली इंस्टेंटेनियस इक्वेशन इज इक्वल टू ई इज इक्वल टू ई एम साइन ओमेगा टी. सो गाइज, आप यहाँ पर ओमेगा जो है वो एंगुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी या एंगुलर वेलोसिटी आप जिसको बोलते हैं. सो ओमेगा इक्वल टू 2 पाई एफ. You already know omega equal to 2 pi f. F is the frequency in cycle per second. So now यहां पर f की value put कर दीजिए. Just put the value of frequency over here and that is equal to 50 hertz. So it becomes 2 pi into 50, then 100 pi radian per second. So now we can write the first equation is small e, that is instantaneous equation voltage. That is equal to EM sin omega t. So 5 sin 2 pi f t volts. So guys, this will be our first instantaneous equation of voltage. And then you can write also in place of omega t, you can write down theta. Theta and omega t is basically same. Okay, so you can write it down and also you can write it down E is equal to EM sin 2 pi f t. And then last equation आप यहां पर लिख सकते हैं guys, E is equal to EM sin 2 pi t upon t, because t is reciprocal of frequency, t is time period, f is frequency. So guys, दोनों reciprocal होते हैं, तो आप यहां पर f के जगह पर लिख सकते हैं 1 upon t. So you can write it down in place of f, that is 1 upon t. So 1 upon t is equal to f, or f equal to 1 upon t. So you can just put the value 5 sin 2 pi t upon t is equal to 1 upon 50. So guys, this will be your instantaneous equation. Okay, so this is our second problem. You can see over here on your screen, an alternating current of frequency 60 hertz has a maximum value of 12 ampere. So first write it down the equation for instantaneous values and find the value of the current after 1 upon 360 second, time taken to reach 9.6 ampere for the first time. In the above cases, assume that time is reckoned as 0 when current wave is passing through 0 and increasing in the positive direction. So guys, yahan par aapko jo values di gayi hain, the values are given over here. F is equal to 60 hertz, you can see, and the maximum value of current is 12 ampere, F equal to 60 hertz. So you just find out the value of omega. Omega equal to 2 pi f, so 2 pi into 60, that will be equal to 377 radian per second. So our first equation will be the instantaneous equation of current will be I is equal to Im sin omega t. You already know this equation. So in place of maximum current, Im is given 12 ampere, then sin omega we already calculated 377. So just put in this equation and it becomes I equal to 12 sin 377 t. And then our second point is, guys, we have to find the value of the current after 1 upon 360 seconds. So time ki value aapko yahan par di gayi hai, guys. So just put small t is equal to 1 upon 360 seconds. So see the equation. So just put in place of small t, t is equal to 1 upon 360 seconds. So guys, it will be the instantaneous equation of current will be like 12 sin 377 into 1 upon 360. So it becomes 12 sin 1.0472. Aur ye jo hoga ye radian mein hai, guys. This will be in radian. So just okay, put your calculator in radian mode and then calculate sin 1.0472 and then calculate this value. So it will be equal to 10.3924 ampere. Okay, so use, there is a note also. Okay, so make a note of that. Sine of 1.0472 must be calculated in radian mode. And then guys, the third point, you can see we have to find out time taken to reach 9.6 ampere for the first time. So guys, यहाँ पर आपको instantaneous value of current जो है वो दिया गया है. It is already given. Then see how can you find. So I is given. This is instantaneous value of current 9.6 ampere. So यहाँ पर just put the value of I, that is 9.6, 12 sine 370. Okay, and then just find out the value of t. So small t will be equal to 2.459 into 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. So guys, this will be your answer. So guys, now see this problem. A sinusoidally varying alternating current has RMS value of 20 ampere and periodic time of 20 millisecond. If the waveform of this current enters into its positive half cycle at t equal to 0, find the instantaneous values of the current at t1 equal to 6 millisecond and t2 equal to 12 millisecond. So guys, just note down the given quantities jo aapko di gayi hai, uski value yahan likh lijiye. You are given RMS value of current 20 ampere. Okay, this is first point. T is equal to 20 millisecond. You have given over here. Periodic time means time period is given over here. That is 20 millisecond. And then just find out maximum current, maximum value of current, that is equal to, you already know IRMS equal to Im by root 2. So guys, Im will be equal to IRMS into root 2. So just find out the value of Im. Maximum current will be equal to 28.2842 ampere. And then find out the frequency, that is equal to 1 upon T, and that is equal to 50 Hertz. So if you will put in place of T, T key value had 20 milliseconds. So guys, if you put this value, the frequency will be 50 Hertz. And then find out omega equal to 2 pi f, you already know. Then it will be equal to 314.1592 radian per second, because frequency is in frequency, the value of frequency is 50 Hertz. So the omega, the unit of omega is in radian per second. And then guys, just use the instantaneous equation of current, I equal to Im sine omega t, you already know. And then just put the all the values, okay, in this equation. Im, which is 28.2842 sine, then omega, 314.1592 into t. So this will be our instantaneous equation, and then you can easily find out, okay, the value of current, instantaneous current at 6 millisecond. Okay, so where t1 is given over here, t1 is 6 millisecond. So if you will put t1 equal to 6 millisecond in this equation, the answer will be equal to I equal to 26.899 ampere. So use your calculator, okay, in radian mode. And then T2 is equal to 12 milliseconds. So guys, it will be equal to minus 16.625 ampere. So you can just calculate. Okay, then see guys, there are two instantaneous equations are given over here. यहां पर आप देख सकते हैं गाइस, देयर आर टू साइनोसॉइडल करेंट्स आर गिवन. सी हियर, द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन इज I1 इज इक्वल टू, ओके, 10 साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस पाई बाई 3, एंड सेकेंड इक्वेशन इज I2 इज इक्वल टू 15 साइन ओमेगा टी माइनस पाई बाई 4. सो गाइस, यू कैन सी, कैलकुलेट द फेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज क्वांटिटीज, ओके, इन डिग्रीज. सो बेसिकली गाइस, यहां पर आप देख सकते हैं, दिस इज द प्लेस ऑफ phase angle. So how much angle it is leading, it is given over here. I1 current jo hai wo plus pi by 3 degree aage chal rahi hai, ya pi by 3 degree means 60 degree. Okay, yahan par aap guys multiply kar sakte hain, agar ye pi by 3 radian mein diya hua hai, so just multiply it by 180 degree by pi, so it will be converted into degree, and pi will be cancelled out, so it will become 60 degree. So guys, ya to pi by 3 radian aap keh sakte hain, or you can say 60 degree. So basically guys, jo first current hai wo pi by 3 radian ya 60 degree aage chal rahi hai, it is leading. And see, the current I2 is lagging minus pi by 4. So guys, this is the place of phasor angle, phase angle. Okay, this will tell us how much the current is, how much degree. Okay, the current is leading or lagging from a particular quantity. So guys, यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं, it is minus pi by 4. Okay, so minus 45 degree. So here, minus 45 degree, it is lagging behind the quantity. So now you just guys draw the phasor diagram. So basically guys, जो formula होता है, you can see the phase angle, you can find out the phase angle between two quantities, you can find out. So the angle of first quantity, okay, phi 1 minus angle of second quantity, phi 2. So this is the formula used for calculating phase difference between two waveforms. So guys, यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं, this is the formula used. So angle phase difference between these two, the phase difference, the angle of first waveform pi by 3. So just put into here 60 degree minus right second phase angle minus pi by 4 or minus 45 degree. So it will become 105 degree. So guys, यहाँ पर आप बता सकते हैं और phasor diagram draw कर सकते हैं और यह बता सकते हैं वेयर I1 इज लीडिंग 105 डिग्री ओके फ्रॉम I2 और I2 लैग्स I1 बाय 105 डिग्री और I1 लीड्स I2 बाय 105 डिग्री. सो गाइस इफ यू कैन ड्रॉ द फेजर डायग्राम, सो ड्रॉ फर्स्ट ओके ऑन x एक्सिस ड्रॉ ए रेफरेंस क्वांटिटी x. ओके दिस इज x, सपोज दिस इज x एंड देन जस्ट मेजर द एंगल 60 डिग्री. Okay, from here, from this axis, measure the angle 60 degree and then draw a line, okay, of magnitude I1. This will be your I1. Okay, aapko draw karna hai how much? 10. Maximum value of current is 10 ampere. So, okay, so take a measurement, okay, in centimeter and then, okay, take the scale and then you can draw I1. And then, guys, you have to measure minus 45 degree from this axis and that is minus 45. So it will be downward, okay, below this axis. So minus 45 and then you have to measure 15 ampere current. Okay, so use scale and use your measurement and then you have to draw just second current I2. So guys, now you will see this will be the total angle between these two waveforms will be 105 degree. So now you can say I1 is leading from I2 by 105 degree. Or I2 is lagging behind I1, okay, by 105 degree. So guys, here you can see this is the formula, okay, already given over here. Whenever you require a conversion, okay, between polar system into rectangular system, or whenever you convert, okay, rectangular system into polar system, so you will have to these formulas. Okay, see here, okay, the polar system represents like this, R plus minus angle phi, while rectangular system will be represented by X plus minus J Y. So this is a complex quantity, okay, J, X is real quantity, Y is imaginary quantity, and J is the operator which will tell you the angle, phase difference. Okay, so whenever you require, whenever you want to convert the polar quantity into rectangular or rectangular into polar, so use this formula, x equal to r cos phi, y equal to r sin phi, and r equal to under root of x square plus y square, and phi equal to tan inverse y upon x. So guys, now here we are given over here the new problem. Okay, so there are two instantaneous equations are given over here. यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं guys, एक voltage का equation है और एक current का equation है. So आप यहाँ पर देख सकते हैं, okay, the voltage equation is 170 sin 6280 t plus pi by 3 volts and the instantaneous equation of current I t is equal to 8.5 sin 6280 t plus pi by 2 ampere. So these are the phase angles. You can see the voltage is this much, the voltage is leading this much angle plus pi by 3 or 60 degree, okay, and the current the angle of current is pi by 2 plus pi by 2 means 90 degrees. So first of all guys, plot the two waveforms and determine the frequency in hertz. So we have to calculate these parameters, then determine the power factor, okay, and then what are the values of the elements. So guys, aap yahan par dekh sakte hain omega ki value jo hai wo 6280 t yahan par diya gaya hai. Omega t ke jagah par, in place of omega t, it is written over here 6280. So just compare it. So omega becomes 6280 radian per second, and then omega is equal to, you already know, omega is equal to 2 pi f. So you can easily find out the value of frequency. So it will be omega upon 2 pi. So it will be equal to 1000 hertz. Okay, so put the value of omega over here. Yahan par aap iski value rakh dijiye. Then guys, two sinusoidal waveform with a phase difference. Ab aapko phase difference find karna hai in dono waveforms ke beech mein. So just use the formula, phase angle phi is equal to angle of voltage minus angle of current. So what is the angle of voltage? You can see over here. Okay, pi by 3. Pi by 3 means 60 degree minus, okay, 90 degree. So yahan par aap dekh sakte hain guys, formula hota hai phase angle phi equal to, pehle wale ka phase angle 60 degree hai, angle of voltage 60 degree minus second current jo hai uska angle 90 degree hai. To guys, aapka answer minus 30 degree. The phase angle will be equal to minus 30 degree. Aur guys, ye minus ye batata hai ki current jo hai wo lead kar rahi hai. Current is leading actually. Okay, you can see from here, yahan par aap dekh sakte hain guys. Okay, the waveform from current leads that for a voltage by 30 degree. Okay, so you can see, ab aap yahan par RMS value calculate kar sakte hain kyunki aapka maximum values are already given over here. Okay, so RMS voltage is equal to Vm by root 2, aur yahan par maximum value di gayi hai 170. So it will be equal to 170 by root 2, that is 120 volts. And RMS value of current is 8.5 by root 2, that will be equal to 6 ampere. And what will be the impedance? So guys, you already know impedance Z equal to VRMS upon IRMS or V upon I. You already know. So just put the values of V and I RMS. So it will be equal to 120 by 6, that will be equal to 20 ohms. And then guys, aap asani se power factor calculate kar sakte hain. The power factor is cos phi, then just put the value of phase angle phi, you already calculated, minus 30. So cos minus theta is equal to cos theta, okay, that will be positive. Okay, whether it is minus negative or positive, it will be cos theta. So it will be cos 30 degree and then leading. So power factor will be 0.866 leading if you calculate. And then guys, aap R or C elements ki value bhi yahan se pata kar sakte hain, because you already know the impedance triangle. Okay, this is the impedance triangle. Okay, where you write R on X axis, X on Y axis, and this will be your Z, and this is the phase angle phi. This is called impedance triangle. So guys, aap yahan se sin phi or cos phi easily find out kar sakte hain, because cos phi will be equal to base upon hypotenuse, R by Z. Okay, you can see. So R is equal to Z cos phi and sin phi equal to X by Z. Okay, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So guys, your formula will be equal to XC. So yahan par jo hai guys, current leading hai, isliye jo capacitor yahan par jo element hoga wo capacitive hoga, isliye aapko yahan par XC likhna padega. So X will be capacitive reactance, that is equal to Z sin phi, you can see, and then just you can calculate Z cos phi will become 20 into 0.866, that will be equal to 17.32 ohm. And then capacitive reactance will be equal to 20 into 0.5, that will be equal to 10 ohm. And then you can easily find out the value of capacitance, that will be equal to C is equal to 1 upon omega X. Okay, you can see, because XC equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. This is the formula for capacitive reactance, 2 pi FC. XC is equal to 2 pi FC ohm. So then just find out the value of C. This is the value of C, and that will be equal to, put all the values over here, and then you will find out 15.92, okay, microfarad. So this will be your answer guys.